Hello, welcome to my channel, Lynn Kelly, author. Today I'm going to read you a real life story titled The Heirloom Vacuum. We inherited an ancient top of the line vacuum from my husband's grandmother. The kind sold by door-to-door salesmen. Grandma had bought it secondhand and used it for ages. I named it Hazel in honor of the old TV show. I'm sure the vacuum was a splendid piece of machinery in its day, but despite taking it in for repairs time and again, it never worked right. At least not for me. George, my husband, was the only person who could get the old clunker to cooperate. Maybe Hazel was partial to his side of the family. Who knows? I had battled with the old rug sucker for over a decade. Then came the day when out-of-town friends were due in 30 minutes. George was out running an errand. Figures. I was already exhausted from preparing an enchilada casserole and cleaning up the kitchen. Plus, I felt beyond frustrated from getting our two youngest daughters to pick up their toys, shoes, and socks. Hazel had a taste for dirty socks. So I hoped the vacuum would cooperate. Come on, Hazel, old girl. I deserve a break today. Every time it was turned off, the belt slipped out of place. Although every so often, the vacuum stars aligned and the belt was still attached from the prior use. I peeked underneath or plugging it in. Darn. Please don't make me put your belt on more than once. I removed the heavy front piece, turned a knob so the inside latch would catch the belt, then twisted the knob back into place to position the belt correctly. Supposedly. Okay, easy does it, girl. I put the front piece back on, then pushed on the tricky little button that had to be depressed in order for the machine to power up. Usually, this required going through the process 5 or 6 times, which meant turning the knob all over again to catch the belt. We're running out of time, I warned, so a little cooperation will go a long way. There were other steps that had to be taken each time, such as hitting a pedal to raise the front piece off the ground and then lowering it when I thought the vacuum was assembled properly. Next, I plugged the cord in, ready to whip the carpet into shape. I flicked the on switch. Aw, man, no juice. Again. On that fateful day, it took numerous tries before the power kicked on. When the electricity finally flowed, Hazel's motor roared and it blew out little puffs of dirt from the doohickey where the hose was attached. Sweat beaded on my forehead, but I was making progress. Just needed to check underneath to make sure the belt was still secured before I began to vacuum. Son of a dirtbag, the belt had slipped off again. So the process began all over. After 10 more tries, 5 with power, but the belt slipped off, and 5 with absolutely no power, I was at my wit's end. I wiped my brow and fanned my armpits with the latest edition of Home and Garden magazine. Must have caused a lot of commotion because my 15-year-old daughter, April, came into the living room and offered to plug and unplug to save me time. Unplugging was an important step since I'm not a risk taker and I didn't want to deal with a mangled hand. By this point, there were dirt patches all over the carpet from shaking the vacuum while disassembling. Look at the mess you've made, stinking rugsucker. The carpet was worse than when I had started, and it looked as though I wouldn't be able to clean up the muck before company arrived. I was so mad, I'm surprised the moisture dripping down my back didn't turn to steam. One more try, I threatened through clenched teeth. I inhaled a breath of grimy air, repeated the routine, then carefully pushed the on button. Nope, still no power. Grrr. The universe had definitely had it in for me. I admit I totally lost it in that moment. Yes, in front of my teenage daughter. Picking up the vacuum, guts and all, I chucked it across the room, not caring whether it broke into a million pieces. Eat dirt and die! It thudded to the floor, but it landed upright. Hazel zoomed to life with power. April and I glanced at each other, eyes wide and mouths agape. I carefully peeked underneath the vacuum, expecting to find the belt loose. I don't believe it. The belt's on, I said. April's eyes grew wider. Same song of the Twilight Zone played out in my mind with a wicked laugh. I vacuumed up the dirt patches, dog hair, and crumbs, and still had a couple minutes left to splash water on my face just before our company arrived. I wish I could say the old vacuum worked like a charm after that. But the truth is, Hazel deposited more dirty piles on our floors than a litter of puppies. The heirloom vacuum had worn me out and caused more aggravation than our four kids did. We gave it to the repair shop so Hazel could become a parts donor or get an overhaul. That was more than 20 years ago. I'd like to think it found a new home with nice owners who had more patience and energy than I did. The end. Thanks for watching. Come back for more Slice of Life, True Story.